sometime when we get the data in a large volume, we have to split the data in multiple sheets. Could be basis on number of records. Let's say you have got 10 agents and you have received 1500 leads. Okay. Now you want to split those 1500 leads across all those 10 agents. So you don't want to do this job manually, because right now I'm talking about only 10 agents. There could be hundreds of agents where you have to, or to whom you want to distribute the leads on an everyday basis. And the condition is that you have to create a different sheets, multiple sheets. That means a single dedicated sheet for a particular agent. Now, in such cases, how are you going to do it? Of course, manually we do it, right? We go and we filter out first 10 leads to one agent one, then agent two, then agent three. Likewise, you will keep on doing it. This could be a tedious task. Simple if you have got very small data set and you have got very limited number of filters or criterias, right? Say for if you have got three, four sheets, then it's easier for you to split the data. But then also it is going to take few minutes. If you want to save that time, then VBA can be the one-time solution for you. Okay. One-time activity or one-time efforts we have to put to write a program. And next time onwards, when you click on a button, irrespective of how many records you have received, as soon as you just click on a button, then the data is going to be split on multiple sheets. The objective, I have already made it clear to you guys. I am simply going to copy the first. Let's count how many records we have got. We have got total 755. Okay. And let's assume that I want to distribute 100 records. Okay. So if I want to know how many people are going to have these 758 leads, so we will simply take out the total number of data or records and we will divide it by 100. Okay. Now it is 7.58. So we can either use the roundup function. Okay. So that is going to tell me the next integer. Okay, or we can use the ceiling function here. Okay, ceiling function also rounds a number upwards to the nearest multiple of significance. Okay, then we will add sheets. We are going to count the total records. Okay, second will be to find out how many sheets are required. Okay. Third, we will start. Okay. We will loop through each sheet, because now once we know the number, we know that how many sheets are required to be added. So we will start with the loop and then we'll first add. So first add the new worksheet. Okay. Once the worksheet is added, okay, then we have to rename the worksheet. Okay. Once the sheet is renamed, then what we are going to do, we are going to copy the data from the data sheet to a new sheet. Okay. Now, you need to understand when we are going to create a new worksheet, we can define that in a variable. Okay. So then we can use that variable to copy this copied data into a new worksheet. Okay. Once we know the data has been pasted, the next step would be to change to know the next 100 records. Okay. So for that, we will be needed one more line of it. Okay. And then after that, whatever actions we want to do, we will be going to do the same. I expect the screen on my system. Now I'll just go and will insert a module. So live project data we are going to partition, right? Activity. Okay. So we discussed that we need to know how many records are there, correct? So I'm going to begin with a comment here. I'll say declare required variables. Okay, so I'll say dim total rows. I need to count, so I say total rows. I'm not assuming more than 32,000. Okay, so I'm going to declare it in integer. Okay, then let's also count the columns, since we are going to make this this program work dynamically. So we can also count columns if required, otherwise we can skip it. Okay, once we are done with this, then we said we also need to know how many sheets. Okay, so for sheets also we would be needed one variable. All right, so here I come, I declare variable for requiring number of sheets. So I say required sheets. Okay, and then this is going to be a number, so I declare it as integer only. And then to loop through each sheet, I would be needed another variable. For that also I use variable called I, and then start number. Okay, and then this also I'm just going to say integer to store a sheet. So for that I say destination sheet as worksheet. So here I declared the variable. Next thing I do, I come here and I say total rows. Now I need to find out the total rows. So which method I should be using it here? Last row. Last row I can find out, or I can find out the last cell. I come onto B column and I say take the last row position of B column. Okay, similarly for columns I go in the seventh row and Excel to left, it is going to give me the column position. Okay, so I got the row number, so I can come here finding total rows and total columns. So once I get these two information, right, two total rows and total columns, after that I need to know how many sheets I have required. Okay, so let's calculate. Okay, and how are we going to do it? So I'll say required sheets. So here I use worksheet function and I say ceiling, and here I'm going to use total rows, and since I need to divide it 100 records, right, to each participant, each agent, so I am just dividing it 758, whatever the number came, right, by 100. And then I say let's keep the significance value as 1. Okay, and I want to start number, I want to keep it as 7, because 7th is the starting number position. And next I'm going to now start with the loop. So here I say start with for I loop. Now what this will be doing, so this I'm saying to counter till the required number of sheets. So if the required number of sheets is going to return as 8, okay, that means my loop is going to run eight times. Okay, so with this loop what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a new empty sheet and will rename it. Okay, so here I come and I set the destination sheet, and I say simple, when I'm going to start the loop, immediately I will add the sheet because I need the sheet for working. Okay, so here I come and I say sheet, I want to add, where I want to add, do I want to add it before this or after this? I want to add after this. Okay, so I just ignore the first argument and for the second. Now how do I count how many sheets are already there, because it needs a number. So for this, so I say here I need to add sheets, and then after, okay, and it needs a number, it needs a number. Okay, which sheet number? So I'm going to use sheets.count. So what this method is going to do, let me just show you. It tells me how many sheets are there. Okay, so this sheet number is going to return here. Okay, so it is going to add after that sheet number, and then I just simply close this function. Okay, so now sheet has been added, but I want to give a customized name. So what I am going to say here, I say this sheet, the sheet that has been just added, okay, because it has been set it to destination sheet variable. So I use this object variable and I say the name of this sheet is going to be customized one. All right, so I say sub data and then I just take the counter value. So I is going to be 1, then 2. So I'm just going to say sub data 1, sub data 2, sub data 3, likewise. Next step I have to do, I have to copy the data. Okay, and what I have to copy, I am going to copy the first 100 records. Okay, so I have to start it from 7 and simply I'll say plus 99. Okay, so because 7th we are starting, so 7 plus 99 is going to be total 100 records, right? We will be picking it up. Okay, so here I come and I simply say that let's first, because as soon as you add any sheet, it activates that sheet. So we are going to activate data sheet back. Okay, so here we come and we say sheets data and activate. All right, so this sheet is going to be activated and then immediately I say I know the column A and here we have start number. So this is the first cell. Until where I want to go, I want to go start num plus 99. Okay, and how many column? For columns we have already calculated here. Okay, so I want to start from A7 plus column, total column is called D, so D106. So it is going to select, if I come here, it's going to select. So if you notice till here the 100 records are counted and it's going to select this much of data. All right, directly from here when I just selected the data, I can copy this data and I have to provide the destination. So here only I come and I say in destination sheet, okay, I want to paste it in A7 onwards only. So first time it will add sub data sheet 1, so it will add these 100 records to that sheet. Okay, and then after that, once it is done, we need to reset the starting number position also. Okay, so what I do here, I come immediately and I say start number, start num, okay, is going to, because start number position was set to 7 earlier, it has already copied 100 records. So the next time when it loops, it starts back from here. So what should be the start number value? It should be 107. So that it comes here and then it selects the next 100 records and then moves to the next sheet. Okay, so for that purpose, we have actually increased 100 or added 100 to the start number value. Okay, so it will help us following code line will help to jump on 100 or next 100 records. Okay, now this is done. So this much, if we run it, it's going to split the data into 7-8 different sheets depending on the data size we have got. Okay, my data here is starting from 7th row, right? And where is the heading? Heading is in 6th row. Okay, and I am copying the data from 7th row. Okay, A7. So what it is going to miss? The heading part. All right, so we are not copying the heading. Let me just run this program first, okay, and show you what is going to happen. So here I come, I just set the breakpoint here. So I come here, I press F5. Now it's saying debug error. Why it's saying debug error? Total columns. Okay, total calls. I have written total call here. Okay, now it will work. And here I come, F5. Do you see that it is selecting till column C? Why? Why it is selecting till column C? Because should have 4, but because here we don't have any value, that is why it was returning C7. Okay, so now here I come. Now I'm going to run step by step. I know how many records are there. 761. Let's check this out. Yes, 761, not 761 records, but total number of rows I have got it here. And then I have got 4 columns. Okay, so here it is going to divide the number of rows by 100, and then it tells me total 8 sheets are required. Okay, and then start number is set to 7. Now it goes and it first adds a sheet. Sheet is added here, and then sheet is renamed here, and then the data sheet is going to be activated. And now here it selects the data from 7th row till 106th row, and then copy the data. Though you don't see here, but the data has already been pasted here. Okay, and now it will come to the next sheet, right? And it will move and add another sheet and will add the data, right? The next data is going to be selected. Okay, so if we look at here, Dev Dutt Singh, right? So here it is starting with Gopal Sharma, and in next it is starting from Janak Raj. Okay, so the next 100 records are being pasted into the next sheet, right? Here we go. 1, 2, right? And I'll just set the breakpoint here also, so that when it adds all the sheets, we can see all 8 sheets are added. What is missing here? We don't see the heading here. Okay, so now what could have we done? We could have copied. So now what I can do here, I can write one more loop saying for each, okay, for each desk sheet in this workbook dot worksheets. So next desk sheet, I'm using the same variable here, and I say if the destination sheet is not equal to the data sheet, okay, then simply go, and what it needs to do, it needs to copy, okay, it needs to copy the data from data sheet, right? This headings have to be copied. So I say sheets data, and then I say range, and I select from 1 till 6th row, entire row dot copy, okay. And then where to paste? In destination sheet from range A1 onward. Okay, so now it will move to sheets data sheet, and then from here till here it will copy all the rows and will paste it into destination sheet. All right, so I'll show you here when I come how it is going to do it. So let me just destination sheet. First destination sheet is which one? It is output sheet actually. So data sheet, so it's not going to be executed. Next sheet is subdata one. Here it comes, it copies. Now if you look at carefully, currently we have empty row, okay? So now I come and it has pasted. So it has copied and pasted including the header, all right? Next thing, what I need to do, I want to set the column width. If you look at here, this column A is shrink, right? So what is the column width here? It is 2. So I want to set the column width of this sheet also to 2. So what I'll say here, I'll come here, I'll say desk sheet, okay, and range A, you set any column, okay, and then simply pick the column width and say column width is equal to 2. So now here we set it, right? So what it is going to do, this line is going to reset this column width, okay, and then what I want to auto fit the column width. Okay, so here I come and I say desk sheet dot range B6 current region to columns and auto fit. Okay, this particular part is going to fit the column width. Here we have seen that we came here, we have copied data, we have also copied the headings, and now whatever you want to do, okay, you can do it here. So since we have ended, right, I guess, yeah, we have ended the program, so that is why it has finished. So let me just do one thing, I select all these sheets and I delete it, okay, and we will run once again. Okay, now let's see whether it is working fine or not. So I press F5, F5, you can see the sheets are getting inserted, and then I just run this loop also. And now when I just go to every single sheet, you notice that, let me just expand this, so we can see the data has been auto fit, right? And 100 records have been pasted here.